dreadfully, die dreadfully.
Reason had gone, his mind filled with memories of times past. He rose from his thinking stool and walked the busy streets where people hustled along, each person with a task in hand. He was confused. What would he do without his woman of silk? That of boiling lava. A great tension had coiled itself up inside him. Giving way, he threw her to one side and grabbed her companion, a mysterious man with dark, forbidding features. His hand went into his pocket, and there, for impatient fingers, was the knife. It is the sentence of this court that you be taken from whence you came. And on the 3rd day of March, in this the year of our sovereigns, you be taken to a place known as the Tower, and there be hanged by the neck until you are. are dead. And may God have mercy upon your souls.
Who is this person? Monday's gone, but it's nearly persistent. What is this problem? Can we not help them? Show them the right way. How many things can you count in your own life? What do they all say?
I don't need your possessions. Don't show them off to me. I'm free. Keep your mind on your own life. Your wife's not for me. Be free. Can you see that in this world we should learn to live and love while we're together, and all around us we will find a peace of mind,
a peace of mind. In your mind there's great danger. Nicer than yours. If that stranger's car is faster than yours. Oh no, this is wrong, friend. You must defend what your life is worth. Do not bother what your neighbor has that's better than yours. Not your fault you've been caught in life's grand masquerade. Thought you were.